When students first learn how to identify trees, they often focus on very discrete objective characteristics. So if it's deciduous trees, looking at the leaf shape, leaf size, venation pattern, are the leaves compound or simple, is the branching opposite or alternate, or if it's and looking at the flowers and fruit, if it's a coniferous tree, looking at the needles, are they bundled in fascicles, are they individual, is it scale-like, are they needle-like, what are the cones like, what do the cone scales look like? So those are important characteristics and they're important to learn, but they often don't serve you as well in the forest because, especially in a mature forest, if you look at a tree, it might be 30 meters up before you encounter needles or leaves. And sometimes you might have binoculars with you, so that can be helpful for that, but you aren't going to be able to examine those things up close. You might be able to look on the ground, see if you can find any cones or leaf litter, and that can give you some clues, but when you find a cone on the ground here or a needle on the ground, you don't know if it came from this tree or that tree or that tree. So the leaf litter will tell you what species of trees are in the area, but it won't necessarily tell you about an individual tree. So what you will rely on more and more as you become more experienced is actually just the bark. And bark is a really tricky one to learn because it's a little bit like if I showed you photos of 20 people and one of them was your friend, you would immediately recognize who that person was. But if you were to have to describe to me which of those people was your friend just by the facial characteristics, it might be hard for you to put it into words in a way that I could understand and figure out who you were talking about. It's a little bit similar with bark. I can look at this bark and I can tell you that this is a Western red cedar bark, and I look at it by kind of knowing what the color is. I know that on the whole the bark is relatively flat, it's not platy. I know that it's in long, thin strips. And I can tell you those characteristics, but what those words mean to you might be a little different than what they mean to me. So what you really need to do to learn to identify trees by bark is just get a lot of practice. So I'm going to try to give you a little bit of practice in these videos, but the more time you spend in the forest, the more time you spend looking at trees, soon you'll be able to just look around and know what all the trees are just by their bark. You won't even need to look up at the foliage. And another thing that you develop over time that's kind of similar to bark is looking at tree shape. So eventually you'll be able to drive down the highway and look out the window and know what tree species you're seeing just based on the shape of the trees and the arrangement of the foliage and where you are. You might know which species that you would expect. So it's kind of interesting. The very easy things to teach and learn are things like what's the shape of the cone scales, are the needles bundled in fascicles, etc. So those are important characteristics, but bark is something that is probably something you're going to rely on more for tree identification, but it's a skill that you have to hone and practice over time. Here's a big Douglas fir. This is probably 80 or 90 centimeters in DBH. So if you look at the bark, it has these big plates and kind of has some deep but not especially narrow furrows in between those plates. And often it can have a little bit of a reddish color to it like this. This greenish color is from lichens growing on it, which really contrasts with that, but you don't always see this greenish color. So this is just one example of a very large Douglas fir. Contrast that Douglas fir with this Western red cedar. So they're similar in sizes. I mean, this Western red cedar is quite a bit smaller. It's maybe 50 centimeters in DBH. But look at this bark. It's very smooth and flat in comparison to the Douglas fir, though it still has quite a bit of a pattern. Do you see it has these thin strips? So lots of thin strips running down it. And they're very peely and kind of fibrous. You can peel them off very easily. It's a brownish with maybe a little bit of a reddish color to it. So this is what a mature Western red cedar looks like. Here's a much smaller Western red cedar. The bark looks pretty similar to the bark on the larger Western red cedar. It's maybe a little bit smoother, a little bit less coarse, but you still have this kind of dark brownish with maybe a little hint of red or purple bark that has long, narrow strips that are kind of peely. So Western red cedar, the bark doesn't change as much between smaller trees and bigger trees. Here's the bark of a moderate-sized Western hemlock. So it doesn't have those long strips like the Western red cedar, but it also doesn't have those big blocky plates like the Douglas fir does. So we have small plates. There's relatively shallow furrows in between. The texture is a bit just finer textured on the whole. And the color, brownish with maybe a hint of red. Sometimes you can get a little bit of a purplish to it as well.